So the penalty by the offense, and now they face a first and 15.
Ohio! Here we go! Grand 38! Grand 38!
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and no more. The linebacker Ryan Shazier there to make the tackle.
Now that result is no surprise. This team is bringing back memories of what? The 85 Bears, the 2000 Ravens. Those teams were so great against the run, they made you abandon any plans of doing that when you played against them.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, and it's the Bengals with a football to begin quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series.
Let's go! Grand 38! Grand 38! Flex round! Flex round!
Let's go!
Flex round!
Now they try the right side here, and not much running room. Down to the 32. It's a gain of four, but they're still looking up here at a tough third and 11.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
13th play now on the opening drive. Will this be the lucky one? It's third and goal. Third down, he'll drop to throw. Complete to the right side, it's Eifert. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field.
Flex round! Flex round! Come on, let's go! Ohio! Ohio! Oh.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Second down following the run.
Come on, let's go!
Ohio! Ohio!
Flex round! Flex round!
Play clock winding down. They stay on the ground. This time it's Johnson. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. Just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
Let's go!
And the play clock's running down. Back to throw here. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well. And every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
And he missed it. It's no good, and this will remain a scoreless game. Well, that hollow metal sound is the bane of any kicker's existence, and here, that sound is going to keep our game scoreless.
And you can see him give that body English as the ball was in the air. Come on, baby, come on! But no dice that time.
Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Intended receiver was David Johnson, and it'll be second and 10.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well, and he didn't get that done on that play.
On second and 10, Goff. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you go lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
On first down, it's gone. Underneath for Johnson. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. Call it a pickup of 7, and it'll be second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he gets receiver hit and hit hard.
And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here at 2nd and 12.
Let's go! 3-19!
Aguilar in motion left. Here's Goff now on 2nd down. Trying to set up the screen, and it's intercepted. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will bring it back. It's a pick 6 for Bengals TD. Short throw pick 6 right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. Fielded about a yard deep. And there's a flag on the field. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And following the pick 6, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick 6. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throw.
And that's caught inside the 30. A big play that time for Pittsburgh. And even 60 yards. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a
And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
Leopard! Leopard!
first down carry here for Johnson. And he stopped immediately there. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. And they're going to speed things up here.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up the defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run.
Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Adam Jones. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. Four yards remaining now on second down. On second down, here's Goff. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Carlos Dunlap in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about eight. And now the Bengals are going to call another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So a big sack on second down. Now let's see what the offense has in store for third.
All right, here we go. Over.
In motion right is Bryant. Just beating the play clock is gone. He's going to wind up and air it out. Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant. And that's going to make it fourth down. So on fourth down, the Steelers call on the number of Chris Boswell for the field goal try. This will be spotted at the 37, so it's a 47-yard attempt. That is inches from the upright. It's no good. Wide to the left, and this score will stay right where it is. So it's an empty possession, and as a kicker, not the way you want to start your day's work.
And now each team's missed a field goal here so far, Brandon, so apparently neither guy is immune.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field. Now Jones is hit. He lost the football. And it, look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. And he takes it back to the house. A fumble recovery for a Steelers score. So the defense forces the fumble. They get the score. And a guy on defense becoming offensive there, Charles.
And you know they love that. Any guy on defense loves to pick up the ball and have it in his hands and try and score himself. In this case, that's exactly what happened.
He'll be singing in the shower post-game. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And out now, here come the Bengals. Jones. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. It's a five receiver set. Three to the left, two to the right. Eifert, the man in motion. Throwing, Jones. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass.
Flex round. Here we go.
They'll send the big tight end in motion right.
Ohio.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's got Curse. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. and now they're in the hurry-up.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double-covered, but how about this guy? He's double-covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
This is caught at the 20. A big play there just before halftime. 41 yards. And the young buck showing that ability, that agility to dance outside of the pocket, complete the deep ball.
And don't think for a second.
And the Steelers signal for another timeout. So as they take it over, we step aside. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. And Hartley able to knock it through. So we've reached halftime here in the Queen City, and it's the Bengals leading this one. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. That's fielded in the end zone. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Back to throw, Goff. Looking deep downfield. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Second and 10. Goff again. His throw incomplete. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver. And it'll be 3rd and 10 now. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
And the offense looks to pick up the first here on 3rd after that incompletion. Play action. It's gone. He's got time. Dancing to his left. Now he's going to throw a fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Adam Jones. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Second down, 9 yards to go. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together.
Let's go!
Time running out here on the play clock. Looking to throw. And Graham's got it over the middle. A gain of 4 on the play. And that'll make it 3rd down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They're going to look to throw. And he finds Jimmy Graham. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. For the offense lining up, first and 10.
Ohio! Ohio! Come on, let's go!
They'll send a receiver here in motion right. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom! Quick, and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Here we go, Ohio, Ohio. Flex round. Come on, let's go.
Now Jones is hit. He lost the football, and it looks like Steeler football. It is. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field.
With no running backs in the backfield to help pass protect, all the receivers in their patterns, these are going to be hot routes. If they sense a blitz or pressure on the quarterback, they've got to be prepared to break routes off early and get the football. In this case, never even had a chance. They popped the ball free in the backfield.
The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's brought down. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
Oh, Brandon, this one hurts my heart as a former defensive back. Out in the open field, you've got a chance to get down this receiver. Instead, he breaks through you. You'll hear about this in the film room and from your teammates.
First down, gone. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Bengals offense now, they head back onto the field. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. After the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
Ohio! Ohio! Black Brown! Here we go! Black Brown! Black Brown!
Play clock winding down. Now it's the Princeton man. This is Spencer Ware. And he'll find some room to get this up to about the 14. That's going to be a 6-yard gain. It leaves him with third down and just a yard to go. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding clock.
And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run. And the play clock's running down. They run again with Ware. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
And partner, in a lot of short yardage situations, you'll see the linebackers step up into the gaps, what we call mugging the line of scrimmage, to make sure they take away all spaces, all creases. That one worked really well for them.
Yeah, only needed a yard, instead went backwards. Now the Steelers put a stop to the action with a timeout defensively. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Here's Kevin Huber now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. This is fielded at the 27. Back now in Cincinnati. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Getting a look at the Wildcat here.
Here we go!
And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people, because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers, because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they will just roam and hit.
And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll come out in the pistol. Johnson on the counter. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up the play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
Okay, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now a play fake here on first down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's brought down. It's a gain of 14 there. And it's good enough for a Pittsburgh first down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Fresh set of downs here. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Play clock hit zero. Don't know what went wrong there, Charles, but it's going to cost some 5 yards.
Has to be some organization from the sideline. Sometimes when you're trying to decide on what play to send in, the play caller has to move a little bit faster.
To throw, and it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
In motion left is Funchess. Again, Goff. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Carlos Dunlap in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
Well, this is what happens when you get behind the chains, as people like to say, when you have obvious passing situations, hard to vary it up and fool a defense.
And you hate those situations if you're an O-lineman, right?
Oh, without a doubt, because you just know they're coming, and you never know exactly how. They can be exotic in their blitzes, or their athletic ability just takes over.
And he motions the wide receiver. Third and long, it's gone. To the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
And Boswell's kick is good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the fourth quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And at this stage in the game, every play is magnified here as we get down to the nitty-gritty.
Let's go! Brad 38!
Eifert, the man in motion.
Ohio! Ohio! Flex round! Flex round!
Throwing, Jones. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he takes it all the way down to the 32. A big play there for Cincinnati. 41 yards. Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident, and then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're...
Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. So second and nine, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here. They come out here in the eye.
Flex round! Flex round! Let's go!
They come up in an offset eye. On second down, Johnson. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. He lost two there. And it's third down.
And as we've seen throughout this season, it's no picnic trying to score touchdowns against this unit. They're ranked number one against the run. But it's also difficult because it's not easy to throw the ball against them either.
Thank you. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Let's go.
They'll bring a receiver in motion right. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down. Now a whistle and I think a penalty here for a delay. No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. And Hartley able to knock it through. And the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. All right, so time to reset here. It's a huge kick there, gives them the lead, but they've got to be careful that their celebrations aren't a little too premature.
You're exactly right about that, because there still is time for the other guys to run a few plays and get into field goal position. So this defense is going to need to come up with one final stop if they're going to get out of here with a victory.
Aguilar in motion left. They'll look to throw. Funches with a catch over the middle. And he's brought down. They'll get 17 yards there. And the Steelers are going to have a first down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. And he clocks it with just 10 seconds left. Still left on second down.
Back in the NFL, here we go. All right, here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
He's back to throw. That ball's caught. Aguilar, right side. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. What a hard-fought, low-scoring game. A tough one to lose always, partner.
For the losing team, not beautiful. But for the winning team, that's almost textbook old school football. And you know I loved it.
So for Cincinnati, it took a while, but they finally get that first win after four straight losses. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Chicago Bears next week. Meanwhile, for Pittsburgh, the loss will move them back to 3-2 on the year. And they'll have a chance at redemption next week at home against the Indianapolis Colts. So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. It's a win for the Bengals as we say so long from Cincinnati.
Now I've been in New York, Texas, Midwest, and it all reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A-A-T-L-M-I-A-D-M-V. All reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A.
New York, Texas, Midwest, and it all reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A.
Got some out in Dallas, now I'm smelling like LA. Met a from Miami to the Machiavelli. Left the kids on the belly, left the vid on my celly. She ate like spaghetti, I'm hitting gas and dready. Met some killers in Memphis, like they from Oakland. Give me my flowers while I can smell them. Ain't talking about roses, literally I'm lean. Mix it like a bought it in Nashville. Then I woke up in Tulsa, Oklahoma. It's sunny California, but nothing like Compton. It's more like Calistoga, and it's hot as Arizona. I pop me a Fresno, hard colder than Minnesota in October. Don't interrupt, darling, I'm in the zone. Why does everywhere I go just remind me of home? You know that state of gold with the bed. Them other places come close, but they don't compare.
Now I've been in New York, come on, Texas,
yeah,
Midwest, and it all reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A-A-T-L-M-I-A-D-M-V. All reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, eh?
California, no place like California.
Fresh off a flight to Boston, got a BZ in Maryland that I pipe too often. Headed right to Austin, most likely flossing. Tight, exhausted, high as a forklift. Handful of goons out in Colorado. Any given afternoon, you can catch a hollow. Honestly, it's the same out in Richmond, Virginia or California. Either state, you can get it. I done seen everywhere from Russia to Delaware, trust me, I'm well aware. Barcelona to Bel Air, Petty to the Detroit. Don't tell him he saw how heavily he balls. Every project, every seashore. And I ain't content trying to see more. Nomadic, I probably wind up alone. All it takes is a melody to remind me of home.
Now I've been in New York,
come on,
Texas,
yeah,
Midwest, and it all reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A-A-T-L-M-I-A-D-M-V. All reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A.
California, no place like California.
Chainz. Ow.
Caught up in my... Put your head on backwards, then skate off after engaging laughter about what just happened. Napkins get sent to mammies, is that too graphic? Catch you in traffic, you sitting daffy like stealing candy. My ceiling's absent, my wheels are massive, my friends assassins. All of us, our mothers queens and our women dancers. My river's rapping, my fin is splashing, my gills are flapping. I bit some matches, then sip something and kiss the dragon.
I'm really rapping, no fingers snapping, them packing. Y'all slipping, my swag is dripping, so here's a napkin. What's really happening, verbal attacking, I'm showing passion. Know what I mean, see, I'm the king, like I'm from Akron. I'm going overboard, somebody call the captain. And when it comes to getting checks, I always want the fat ones. I'm so, I can sing to a chandelier. My flow a glass of spade and yours a can of candle.
Too many buttons. Not enough, these fucking, the SWAT is coming. Shoulder, no shoulder shrugging, that's your nugget. Stick it like acupuncture and Magnus honey. Knock on the side door 3 times and have your money. Or get to stepping like Kappa stomping. I slap. I'm having lunch with Italian Sonny. Don't ask the subject. Lord, why you took rabbit from me? He say don't ask me nothing. Too many bodies, too many bundles. Not enough. These bugging, I heard they stun you. It's gonna be trouble. We come through and catch you while you cuddle. Barrels like tunnels. Don't even mumble.
I'm back to balling. I'm in the back full of only. The scene in the queen playing past Detroit. Ready turkey, spaghetti, and castor oil. That's turn your guillotine to a fashion show. In 4 minutes, I turn this into forensics in a foreign car with a foreign. It's long-winded, paper long, and you taking long. You just don't get it. Hung the phone up on Say Tony, want a song with me. Hotter than Mississippi, the summer of the 1950s. Get pulled over for swerving like high officer. When he asked me why I was swerving, I'm swerve officer.
I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself.
Got a mansion, a condo, a cabin, I sleep in my phantom. Dancing with the stars to the Star Spangled Banner. I change your channel, I change your pattern, I ring your Saturn. I your madam, she get and I shake the ladder. I make her take her, then gather and calculate the data. I listen up for the snakes or the baby rattle. I play the shadows, don't play no games, I straight get at them. I'm on a all day, like it's my favorite album.
I play the sound when the Cayman Islands. Dancer. If I don't get the car first, I have a temper tantrum. I'm innovative, I demonstrated this, played it. I don't care if you owe me it. You need to pay me. I kiss your lady, then kiss the baby. Get situated, get keys off table and leave her. I really made it, get it made. Won't wrestle, cause I spatula all you action figures.
This tiny like a spider on a spud web. I got some on my thumbnail. I feed it to my girls, they say, yeah.
I'm doing this for an L. When I go, I'ma leave for the bell. I told you did like a Chevy. I want a Ferrari in yellow. Just so I can match all my yellow. I've been a player since elementary. I got more bars than a penitentiary. I got a that hangs several inches.
I can make it bounce by myself.